Sound design.
All right, so what is the difference between Smaart, SATlive, SysTune, and SIM3? And how do you know which one you should buy? So I'm gonna talk about that in today's video. But before I do, I wanna say thank you to everyone who has been watching the videos, making comments, sharing the videos, asking questions. The whole reason I'm doing this is for that kind of engagement, right? So when you guys ask questions, and that makes me think like, oh, okay, I need to explain this other thing. And obviously the best things are when I get corrections and people say like, hey, you're doing it this way, but you could do it this way and that would be better. And I learn a lot that way. So thank you for that. Amit wrote in and he said, what's the difference between Smaart, SATlive, SysTune, and SIM3? How do I know which one I should buy? I just did a bunch of videos about shopping. And so I definitely feel like you should go back and look at the one where I talked about which software you should buy, and I'll link to it below this video. But I'll just give a few more details right now just to maybe give you a little bit more information if you're still on the fence and try to give you an overview. So let's start with SIM3. All these other analyzers are what Bob McCarthy would call sons of SIM, and they look very similar. So just to give you a little bit of my history, I started out with SATlive, and I used that for the first 10 years, and I still use SATlive, and that's this guy over here on the right. Then in the last year, I started using Smaart, okay? And I've been learning that for about 6 months, and that's been really interesting and really good. Between then, I was on tour with a circus, and if you guys read my book, you know that in my book, Master Your Craft, there's this chapter, A Day in the Life of a Circus Sound Engineer. And I kind of walk you through our setup procedure. And if you've read that chapter, you know that we use SIM3 on that tour. And we had a bunch of channels of SIM3. So this is what the screen of SIM3 looks like. And it is a hardware-software solution. So the whole thing comes together and is ready to go out of the box. These other solutions are what you might call, you know, some assembly required, like you are building it yourself. But that allows you to use things that you already have and get started right away. And that's the real benefit, and that's what I've been focusing on in these videos. Most of us are not going to go out and buy a $10,000 SIM unit, okay? If you can, if you have that ability, you should. They're great. I have not used SysTune. I know some people love it. I'm gonna talk about it a little bit today, but that's my experience and my history with these analyzers so far. So let's talk about their differences and why you might want to buy one over the other. I think the first thing you should consider is probably whether or not you need to do multi-microphone measurements. Why would you need to do that? Well, it just helps you go faster. Basically, right? Like if you need to verify the horizontal aim of a speaker and you are adjusting the speaker and you want to make sure that off-axis left and off-axis right match, if you have a single microphone, you might need to go back and forth and back and forth. But if you have two microphones and two channels and you can look at those measurements simultaneously, then all of a sudden you can get a lot faster. And this might be especially important if you are often working alone, okay? So you won't need to run out and move your microphone as much. If you need to do multi-microphone measurements, then that means you should not use SATlive. Okay, and this, I think, just comes, it kind of represents, I don't know the background of a lot of these other people, but since I've been using SATlive for a little while, and I interviewed Thomas Neumann on the Sound Design Live podcast, I know that this single microphone approach comes from his personal approach. If you're just getting started, you're most likely going to be using a single microphone, single channel. That's the best way to do it, I think, when you're first getting started, because of the trade-off between complexity and speed. Like, obviously, later on, once you start getting some of these tools and grasping these concepts, then you're gonna wanna start speeding things up. Then you can get into multi-microphone, multi-channel measurements. I don't think you're gonna really need that at the beginning. So if you're watching this video, you're probably one of the people that is starting with single channel, single microphone measurements. But that's the first thing to consider, okay? So if you need to do multi-microphone measurements, then you're gonna need to go with either SysTune or Smaart. And I'm not 100% sure you can do two measurements at once with SysTune, but that is my understanding just from reading their website. Okay, the second thing to consider is what platform you're on. So this is kind of a Mac PC question. And again, if you're on a Mac, this rules out both SysTune and SATlive. Okay, so if you're on a Mac, Smaart is pretty much the way to go. If you're on PC though, you can choose SATlive or SysTune. And the cool thing is they actually have some similar features. I've noticed that, for example, one great thing that comes with SATlive is that you can access it through a remote web client. So you could access and remote control SATlive from a tablet, from another computer, basically anything on the same network where you can open up a web browser. And I believe it functions the same way with SysTune. Compare that to Smaart, where currently you need to have another computer running another, also running Smaart. So you need two computers running Smaart, and then they can control each other. Okay, so Smaart, you don't have that nice web client built into it. Okay, so those are your kind of platform considerations, right? So if you're on a Mac, it's probably gonna be Smaart, or you gotta install Parallels, Bootcamp, so then you can run Windows, and then you're kind of going with added complexity. Again, I've been on Mac for years, and I was still using SATlive. I installed Bootcamp and Windows so that I could run SATlive. And the reason for that is that there is a cost balance here to consider. So let's talk about the money. So I think once you think about, do I need to do multi-mic measurements? What is my platform? And I think then the third question is the price. And then look at the features. Why? There's all these little features that we could get into and talk about, but I have these pictures open here for you to see that they all look pretty similar, okay? You've got a magnitude and an amplitude trace, and those are the things that you're mostly looking at, okay? And you're saving traces and you're comparing them. Now, the way they do that, and then what you can do with those traces afterwards, that's where kind of some of the special sauce comes in, and they have some different features around that. What's really important to understand here is that if you put a lot of time into learning SATlive, for example, and then later want to switch to Smaart, basically everything you learned using SATlive will be transferable to Smaart, because these things are just dumb machines taking in data and showing it to you on a graph. So all the hard work is really in interpreting these graphs and interpreting this data. If you want to switch over to Smaart at some point, like I'm doing now, all my 10 years of experience now using SATlive are immediately applicable to using Smaart, okay? And it would be the same thing if you wanted to switch from Smaart to SysTune or in between any of these, okay? So this choice of which software is not really that big of a deal, and that's why I think the most important things are how many channels do you need to measure at the same time, what's your platform, and then what the price is. So let's look at the price. So starting from the cheapest option, we've got SATlive, which we can get into for 270 euros, which is $327. So if you can get $327 and you've got a PC and you just doing single channel measurements, SATlive is great. If you can't get to $330 together, there are free options, and I have some other videos about that. Okay, you've got Room EQ Wizard and you've got Rita. And those are both cross-platform, free, and they can do a lot of things. And again, you could train on those and then upgrade to SATlive when you get $330. Okay. The next step then would be if you can get $480, then you can get SysTune. And then $595 for Smaart DI. And then Smaart and SysTune both have higher level versions that allow you to do more things. They open up some more features. Smaart DI is just one channel at a time. Okay, so its closest analog would be SATlive in that regard. Okay, measuring one channel at a time, same thing with SATlive. if you need to do those multi-microphone measurements and you need some of the added features of the full version of Smaart, you're gonna need $995. And on the SysTune side, you'll need $780. Very easy to start somewhere and then upgrade. So I started with Smaart DI. I used that for a little while. I even did some workshops on it in the past. And then recently, back in December, upgraded to the full version of Smaart and have been learning that. So there should be something here that meets your platform and your budget, because remember, this isn't the only thing you might be wanting to get. Hopefully all the other pieces you can just start with for free, whatever audio interface and mic you have already, and then this might be the piece you want to do your first investing in. Beyond that, there are a few fun features, and I'm not going to demo those right now, but let me just talk about a few that I can think of off the top of my head right now that might be important or might be fun for you. If you're looking at SATlive and you're trying to decide what are the big sort of operational or functional differences, okay, well, remember, let's talk about just maybe Smaart DI and SATlive, since those are both sort of single channel, one measurement at a time. So you make a measurement, you save it, you move your microphone, you make a measurement, you save it, and then you compare those two. Okay, that's sort of the workflow. One thing to look at is just the way that they save traces. So if I make this window a little bit bigger, so look at these little buttons up here. This is how SATlive works. It has sort of banks of eight. And so you save a trace, you put it into here. You save a trace, you put it into 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You fill those up, then you'll need to go into another bank. Okay, and you can only look at quick traces from one bank at a time. So if you need to be looking at more than 8 traces at a time, you probably want to go with Smaart. I don't know when you would do that. I don't often do that. The nice thing about Smaart is that you can just save traces forever. Okay, and then you can organize them by folder if you want, but you can basically just keep hitting capture, 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 capture all day long, and it'll just keep listing them down here. Both SATlive and SysTune have virtual EQ. That's where you can open up a virtual EQ and you can actually make changes and see their effects on a trace. So you could take several traces and then make a combined trace to see what the average might look like. And then you could start putting in some EQ and you can do all of that without making noise and continue to do a measurement in the room. So you'll still need to look at the response again, but it could save you some back and forth changes, could save you a little bit of time. Another feature that I like in SATlive is the delay suggestion tool. So when I'm doing main sub alignment, it can take, it can just be another good suggestion tool. So I'll still look at the phase response comparison between my main and my sub, and I'll still be thinking, okay, I think this is gonna be this situation. I'll probably need to add delay here, maybe a phase, a polarity inversion here. But then I can also check the delay suggestion tool in SATlive, and it'll say, hey, here's what I think you should do for maximum power or maximum summation through the crossover region that you've defined. And then that can just be another thing where you're like, oh, okay, great, that's exactly what I thought. Or, oh, that's a little bit different, let me investigate why. Another feature I like in SATlive, obviously you guys can tell I just have a lot more experience with SATlive, which is why I know a little bit more about the features. There is a feature called Live Add Trace, where you can basically see, record a trace, record another trace, and then you can look at them together, and you can look at what their summation is going to be at that point where the microphone is, okay? So this would be, you measure your main, you have your microphone position, you measure your main solo, you measure your sub solo, and then you can look at Live Add Trace and actually take its phase into account and see how good your summation is gonna be. And so then you can compare some things and you can say, okay, let's look at what perfect summation would be and then let's take the phase into account. And then you can start to just get more information about what the best choice is gonna be for your alignment there. I should point out that these are features that I didn't get into the first probably 2 or 3 years of using SATlive. Okay, so when you're first starting out, a lot of these features are probably not that important. The first things you're going to be doing are just figuring out how to get things connected, taking your first measurements, and then trying to figure out what to do with the data, right? There are a lot of really simple things that we do with our analyzers when we're first starting, like let's just identify a polarity inversion that are the same in every analyzer, okay? Actually, that's not totally true. I just remembered that in SATlive, there's this little button up here that if it thinks there's a polarity inversion, it'll turn red, okay? So that's another nice little feature. I know it's hard to make these decisions at the beginning, which again is why I wasn't talking about features at the beginning. I was just talking about basic things like, what platform are you running? Like if you're on a Mac, okay, you can't use these two, so don't worry about it anyway. But once you've started using them for a while, or maybe you just do the demos. So all of these come with, I think, at least 30-day demos, right? So you could download all three of these and start using them now. Or download one, use Smaart for a month, use SATlive for a month, use SysTune for a month, and then just pick one. And then moving forward, then you might start to see, you know what? I do main sub-alignments all the time, and I need to be really fast, and I really wish I had delay suggestion tool. Okay, so I'll go with SATlive. Let me know what other questions have come up for you about exactly which audio analyzer you need. Let me know what features you really like. Maybe there's something really important that I skipped that you think is really important. You know, I have limited experience with Smaart and zero with SysTune. So if there's something really amazing about SysTune that I didn't mention, comment below this video and let me know, and hopefully I'll get my own test copy of SysTune pretty soon and have some more firsthand information to share with you.
Sound design. Live.